Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for February the 9th of 2020, well, it is titled To Fly Free in Space. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a spacewalk, but in this case, it is an untethered spacewalk, meaning that the astronaut is not attached to the object that they're leaving, in this case, the space shuttle. So the astronaut is there free in space without an attachment to, say, as I said, the International Space Station, perhaps, or the space shuttle, which was the case here. And this is the astronaut Bruce McCandless II, and he was actually free in space. And in order to maneuver in space, you use a maneuvering pack, and that's on his back, and that weighs about 100 pounds of weight on his back. Of course, out in space, when you are in orbit, you're essentially in free fall, and that means that the pack weighs essentially nothing. So you use that pack and some of Newton's laws in order to be able to move. And what we do is that when the jets of gas are sent out, then it will push you in the opposite direction. So the astronaut wants to go forward, then he shoots a little gas out behind him, and that will push him forward. The other thing we have to remember about this is that out in space, there is also no air resistance and no friction. So once the astronaut starts to move, he will continue to move. So unlike driving an automobile, where you can take your foot off of the gas and slow down because of frictional and air resistance forces, that would not happen here, and the astronaut would continue to move in a straight line at the same speed once he starts moving. So in order to slow down and to stop, you actually have to do this opposite and push a little jet pushing forward, push a jet towards the forward direction, and that would then stop the astronaut's motion. And if you do those two jets exactly the same, that would balance out the initial thrust. So the astronaut would then be able to stop. So it's a little bit different and have to practice being able to maneuver this way because it is a little different than what we're used to. We'd be used to giving ourselves a little bit of force to go forward and then allowing it to slow down, allowing frictional forces to slow us down. But remember, again, that is not the case out in space where there are no frictional forces. And once something is moving at a certain speed, it would continue to move at that speed. Now, this type of spacewalk would be done in order to be able to get to things that are further away than the shuttle. So if you had to get a little further out to get to a spacecraft, a satellite that might have been in need of repair, then this would have been the way you would have to do that. And this is one example from 1984, which was one of the earliest, in fact, he was the first astronaut, along with his partner, were the first ones to be able to have an untethered spacewalk and actually travel alone out in orbit around the Earth without being attached to any other spacecraft. So that was our picture of the day for February the 9th of 2020. It was titled To Fly Free in Space. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Eclipsing Camel. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.